That's just a cover of the song by Wilson Pickett. Terrible. Yuri! There he is. Übermensch.
That's it, original.
So it's about the first one. Just as it was the first one.
What year?
So this one was made 10 years ago, but it was made in this. So the first instruments were made in 1920.
Yes.
Well, please tell Mr. Theremin that it's a very great honor for us.
Yes.
Who are?
I want to say that for them it's a great honor.
They're children in the field. To meet one of such stature and foresight.
So he's also very glad to meet all the people who are involved in this field. Это все из Соединенных Штатов Америки, но из разных городов. Здесь представлены Сан-Франциско, это Стэнфордский университет, Чикаго и Нью-Йорк, Принстонский университет. So I just will say from what cities you are from.
I had some pupil in New York. Yes.
Who is that?
Clara Rockmore.
Oh, yeah. Sure, sure. Yeah.
Have you visited the United States?
I was a short time. I was only 9 years.
Yes. And did you lived in Paris, did you?
9 years it was there.
In New York?
In New York. They have a studio there, special 37 West 54th Street.
What was that?
37 West 54th Street.
Yeah. Did you live in Paris?
Paris, you were
living? Very short time.
Very short time. I would love to know about the origins of the idea.
How
did you? My relative was before, a long time ago, 1915, it was there in Paris. It was that Lansky was killed by Catholics.
So he said up to 1940, he used the English language for everyday life, but now he has no opportunity to speak, and that is why maybe his English is not so distinct. But I think that you understand.
Oh, it's fine to me. Very good.
Thank you for saying my difficulty was not his English, but my ears.
So you continue to work.
What kinds of new things are you doing?
Что вы сейчас делаете?
Вы преподаете?
So he still works at the university. Mm-hmm. See, well, he deals with apparatus equipment of this kind at the university.
Do you practice every day? On the theremin?
Играете на инструменте каждый день?
Oh, can she play it?
Oh, wow, he's a musician as well.
Oh.
Другое дело, что у нас был концерт три дня назад, и пока мы его привезли, то он, конечно, поломался немножко. Еще
ну, хотя бы по
человеку
как-то.
Yes, on this one particular instrument. But then when they brought it back, so it was just a bit...
What is this instrument? This is another. There are 12,000 varieties.
Yeah.
Es gibt so viele verschiedene Varietäten. Varietäten.
Разные вариации, поэтому на разных инструментах там какие-то есть различия, да?
This is incredible.
Тут очень интересная история. Еще в 20-е годы у Льва Сергеевича, когда он демонстрировал этот инструмент правительству Советского Союза, и Ленин был при этом, и он учил Ленина играть на этом инструменте.
So here is a very interesting story about this instrument. In 1920, our host, well, he presented, he has just displayed, exhibited this instrument to our government, of the young government of the Soviet Union, of the Soviet Russian, and Lenin was present there. And, well, he gave lessons, you see, to Lenin, well, how to play.
Когда мы были в гостях летом у Льва Сергеевича, то он показывал, он поставил или меня, или Артемьева, не помню так, и за руки стал так делать, и говорит, что мы намного выше ростом Ленина, потому что Ленин был маленький, он был меньше намного, чем Лев Сергеевич.
And Artemyev, you know, the president of this electronic association. So they also wanted to play something and to take some lessons how to play. And took them by the hands and he said that I remember that Lenin was smaller height. You see, well, he just felt it because Lenin really was small, not yeah. He was very small, and he just remembered this feeling.
Лев Сергеевич. А какую песню вы учили Ленина играть?
Я учил больше гринги, жаворонок.
So it was the song which Lenin studied was the by Glinka. It's Skylark. You know this Skylark.
I don't know this song. How does it go?
Вы вот сейчас, может быть, Лев Сергеевич кого-нибудь из вас научит. Лев Сергеевич, кого-нибудь из гостей научите.
Maybe it's too early in the morning. Maybe it's too early in the morning.
I would love. Okay. 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 Oh, that would be wonderful.
But he's
of the compositions fantastic. That have been composed using the theremin instrument, are there any that Mr. Theremin is most fond of? Compositions other composers.
А у вас есть какие-то любимые произведения других композиторов, которые исполняются вот на этом инструменте? Кто вам нравится? Кого считаете?
Ну, разные были.
Сенсанса.
Сенсанс.
The Swan.
Рахманинов вокалист, по-моему, да?
Рахманинов?
Вокалист.
Oh, yeah. When was that written?
Рахманинова? Рахманиновым это было написано, по-моему, в 20-е тоже годы где-то.
So, somewhere of those years.
А? В России, yeah, когда он
was, uh-huh. he was before he left Russia, yes. for USA. So it was approximately yes. at the same time. Yes.
Кто okay. играл? So, Клара... Как фамилия? Рокмар, да?
Да. Дело в том, что весь этот репертуар, который, кстати, играет Клара, папа играл, все пошло от папы. Это вокалист, я помню, что я папе аккомпанировала, когда ну, маленькая была. И сейчас мне приходится его играть тоже. И Клара играет, то есть этот вот эта классика, там много слева.
Переведи,
да?
So, is it a classical repertoire?
Just looking.
He may have this repertoire, yeah, himself.
Я сейчас не я могу подключить просто. Володя, я включу инструмент.
Ага.
Покажу.
Так, что мне помочь?
Не, не надо, не надо.
А это все есть, да? Есть куда-то? Это была тоже в 20-30-е годы очень красивая. Исполнительница Клара Рокмар.
So, is that beautiful musician, Клара
yes,
Рокмар?
Yes, yes, yes. Она по всему миру yes, yes. исполняла.
And she played it all over the world.
Вот, это она играет в концертном зале.
Yes.
So, she's playing in the old conservatory.
Yes, yes,
yes. Ну, это статьи.
Oh, yes.
Uh-huh. А это... динамики.
Mm-hmm.
Это с кем были сделаны?
Саковский.
Саковский.
This is amazing.
Ну, я включу.
Есть, да?
Ну, сейчас посмотрим, когда пока получит, я видел, мы успокоим.
Ну, кто из вас будет учиться?
О, oh, yes, of course, yeah, of course.
А Джордж снимает. Потом, Джордж, я могу вас снять вместе. Потом.
What should I do?
So, now, well, the Paul will take lessons
Paul,
out
okay.
and you'll
да.
take pictures. Yeah.
But Paul,
yes, sir, yes, sir.
Мы его научили немножко от жава.
Okay, what do I do?
Да, а кто? Так а можем, сейчас он по-другому сделает, а потом расскажет.
Thank you.
Don't touch that part. No, here, this is the part. See, because that changes
things. Вот это не надо трогать. Про. Джордж, this is okay. Мотор, мотор.
This is okay. This is fine. Look, you look.
Oh, и Алис.
So, now, in fact, you can just walk around here and do that.
Please, 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 please.
No, I'm just trying something out.
А как резко сделать? Резкость, резкость, Тоня, резкость где делается? Здесь?
This is not very sharp, see? It is not very sharp. It's alright.
It's okay.
Okay? Все.
Okay. This is the focus here. See, he doesn't understand how to use it. Why don't you fool around with it for a while? See, the main thing, it's fine. See, that's fine, look at me. It's okay.
Fine?
Mm-hmm. It's fine.
Все. Mm-hmm.
Oh my God, tubes, man. Now, it's here.
Резкость, резкость. Тоня, резкость где делается? Здесь?
This is not very sharp, see? It is not very sharp. It's alright.
It's okay.
Okay?
Okay, okay. This is the focus here. See, he doesn't understand how to use it. Why don't you fool around with it for a while? See, the main thing, it's fine. See, that's fine. Look at me. It's okay.
Fine.
Mm-hmm. It's fine.
Все. Sure. Mm-hmm.
Oh my God, tubes, man. Tubes in here. Incredible. Okay, so here we go.
Maximum volume in a way.
Yeah.
And here's the pitch, I think. This one is pitch and this one.
It's gotta be this way.
Thank you.
So it's a very complex place here.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Very beautiful.
Natasha,
я слушал записи Клары Рокнер. Наташа не хуже играет. Правда?
Is somebody taking a picture of her with the camera?
Are we how do you when you do like this, when you say Mm-hmm. Yeah, like what does that mean? When you do this, what does it mean?
Так, раскрываете, закрываете.
Is it a way of fine tuning, making it?
Значит, вы просто ищете какую-то вот там ноту, что ли?
Why do you do that?
Почему вот так? So, right hand or left hand, because it's...
Okay, start with the left.
Ну, начните с левой.
Ну, левой рукой это громкость.
So, you see the volume, the loudness, it's the left hand.
Yes.
Yes.
Uh-huh. But you go like, it's, see, like, whereas, see, you see, here's the difference. Like, when I did it, it didn't work.
And I was trying to,
and I was trying to figure out, when you do like, see, I just go like, that's not enough. You're going, you have a finger movement. See, it's a difference. See if I can.
She changes the math.
Oh, listen to that, and then, but now the pitch, how you do, it's different for the pitch,
So,
she said it's just like wings, because, well, the, yes, the sound.
Because what?
Well, you said your fingers just like wings.
It's when you're
flying.
It's a tight and loose movement at the same time. I wonder if this is something that you...
It must be mass, and changes the capacitance based upon how many fingers are open. She gets these envelopes, you know, she's an envelope generator.
Yeah, so...
I
wonder if that's, it's sort of... I mean, it's real fine stuff, like a violin player. It's like playing. It's very much remind me of the violin method. So, Natasha, did you develop these ideas? You developed these. How long did it take you to develop this way of playing?
So she started, well, 6 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And so,
but I mean, this did someone show you how to do this, or did you make it up yourself?
Just herself.
So you can have your own way of playing. So you can play while you want.
Удивительно.
Well, see, when it is in order, so the musical just wonderful, amazing.
И самое интересное, что каждый папин инструмент он обладает своим особенным, как каждый чаще голос тембр.
And you see, every new instrument of her father is a bit different. Mm-hmm. That it's has its own special timbre and features.
I see.
И у нас был один коричневый инструмент, который мы, к сожалению, еще не починили. Вот он обладал такими тонами, как обертонами, именно глубокого, хорошего человеческого голоса.
The electronic round one before that, but it is out of order and they didn't repair it yet. And it was just an amazing instrument because it has the timbre of a human voice.
When it's broken. Who fixes it?
Когда вот ломается, кто чинит?
А вот интересно, Наташа, так не было серийного производства в государстве у нас, да? Чтобы вот сделало государство такой инструмент?
Ну, нет, конечно, нет. Я думаю, что не было силы того, что папа просто...
Я могу рассказать еще то, что...
Вы скажите ему.
А что?
Нет, он... Не, ну пусть расскажет насчет серийного, это интересно. Интересно, интересно.
This is... Question of the lot production, so he wants to explain.
А что ты хотел?
Спасибо,
Наташа. So, it has different kind of influence. Here is the electromagnetic, electrostatic field.
Mm-hmm.
And by moving my hand, I change this field. And so if I have a hand, for instance, or big one, is a big influence.
Mm-hmm.
If it's smaller influence, as great as possible to play with changing in the high in the pitch, or by movement of hand, or just by movement this part,
yes.
Or with the movement the fingers, such way as it will be possible to play this sport. Some company of New York asking to thank him to make many instruments, 2,000 of instruments. Mm-hmm. For this purpose, I was sent in New York to help this to produce this instrument. So it was made. was also make the other instrument, which was played not just by movement, excuse me, by movement the hands, but by movement all bodies. Mm-hmm. For instance, I can play also, instead to play here, it would play with hand, but possible also change the pitch of the body. And this instrument was made such way, instead of this
the bar, this
it wasn't one big such a thing on the floor, like a fox with you, like a fountain. It possible to change the pitch by movement of control. So this way, it was the lowest sound. And this way, it was the highest pitch. Such way. It possible to play this way. For instance, excuse me. This way, a social test instrument, the name of Solomon, Theremin Box, this instrument, the Theremin was instrument of the same way. It was also in my studio, was sent in Herbst's studio in New York. No, it was different kind of also changing to a different kind of tone colors, different kind of changing of the different kind of sound, tone colors similar to human voices, possible. So it was. No, right now it was impossible for instance to make the instrument for me, for here. On account of this is voices, this is very good for art, for the music, and so and saying in for instance, I worked in university, saying that the music, this is not just such thing which not possible in the program. In university, saying different kind of physical, chemistry, or different kind of thing, but not the artistic thing. Mm-hmm. So that's working right now in university.
You live some incredible things.
Sometimes I give a little concert, but the best concert give my daughter. Same sound like play Clara Rockmore, and also different kind of other thing beside if we will play even more interesting right now than Clara Rockmore play. Also I have in this long time ago I had the people in the United States for dance instrument. I learned this
dance?
This instrument was they ordered the it was also maybe the pupil also on this instrument was they ordered it was also maybe the pupil also on this instrument they played and dance instrument one of the best pupil of mine was one of the very good, my pupil, who have found so play and had some kind of school for dance school, and which was also dance different type of stuff, also dance of this electrical instrument. It was sensation kind of instrument.
Well, I have a lot of questions, but maybe someone else should.
In American universities, you'll be happy to know that the sciences and arts do coexist now.
В Америке будут рады узнать, что искусство и наука вместе сотрудничают. сотрудничают наука и искусство. Американцы будут очень счастливы об этом узнать. Они расскажут.
Я сам с вами был. Я был в Нью-Йорке. I was very glad to have explained. And I also repeat more or less my English. And
when do you see some, have you seen a lot of, I mean, incredible things have happened with this idea over the years? You were talking about a dance, you made a dance instrument. There are people that use this idea that you've made for like museum concerts and like art pieces. Who is that?
Williams. She was Negro.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah? Oh really? From the United States. Lavinia Williams.
Yes,
she was in the United States.
Mm-hmm. Oh wow. Hmm. So you see, we're everywhere.
She's alive right now. She got later on. She was the director of the special studio for dance.
And this is in New York?
And New York, and moved to New York in different kind of studio. I don't remember right now exactly the cities, but in different kind of place, New York, new to United States.
You lived through almost the whole history of the Soviet period. I mean, you've seen all these things happen. You taught Lenin how to play, and like you see Gorbachev.
Вы прошли всю историю Советского Союза, если вы уже встречались с Лениным, а теперь живете в эпоху Горбачева.
I mean,
yes, no, I have in my history big around different kind of history, and in here in Leningrad, and in Moscow, and New York, and in London, Paris, in different kind of cities.
What year were you born?
The most, the longest time I was 8 years. I was in United States.
From 1927, is that correct? 1927?
It was beginning in 1927.
On 54th Street.
1937?
1937.
Yes. Yes.
And then I
was in Russia. Yes. What year were you born?
When I was born?
Yes.
1896.
1896.
We're in Leningrad? Jesus Christ.
In
England.
Yes.
Yes.
Was your education both music and science?
Yes, science and that's...
Образование у вас какое, музыкальное?
Physics, astronomy, and electronics. And also, like in music, on the cello.
On the cello. Ah, I see.
Sorry. Дело в том, что вот даже у Льва Сергеевича сейчас, вот он некоторое время работал над проблемой омоложения организма человека и как человеку стать молодым.
Я не знаю, как...
Да, я не знаю, как ему удалось на, по поводу других свои опыты, но сам он, как по-русски, тьфу-тьфу-тьфу, я стучу по дереву, дай бог, чтобы все было нормально. Когда я учился 20 лет в консерватории, Вот, то Лев Сергеевич преподавал там, и выглядел он примерно так же, как будто законсервировался.
So he said that, well, he doesn't know about the others who took his advices and his problems, but what about himself? You see, he looked 20 years ago, when Vladimir was his student at the conservatory, he just looked just the same as now, and maybe even better.
What are your secrets?
No, I must say, really, I invited some instrument specially to use the have the different kind of experiment in acoustics and also in different kind of life of different kind of animals and our. And this, it was possible to make something to make people younger in 8 years, each 1 year, to be younger. But not, I never did not use for myself. It was just, it was some kind of invention in some kind of instrument in connection with the microscopy for this purpose. And people usually say that right now, if people will live longer, it will be too many people on the earth and on the country, and it will be some difficulties. So ask me now, right now, not occupy this thing and to wait, soon as our different kind of organization for feed, and so it will be better. Then it will be more people, and you will use your instrument.
Mm. You use this. Aha. Uh-huh. Actually, she's 80. No, look at that.
She just looks 20.
Cool. She uses it. Yeah, I see. It works.
Еще просто мы уже сейчас скоро уходим. Вот просто мне хотелось бы, чтобы вот наши гости знали, что у Льва Сергеевича еще была масса изобретений, о которых весь мир говорил. У него была и такая платформа танцевальная, да, называлась и как?
Да.
А? Он на этой платформе человек мог двигаться, значит, извлекая звуки А еще самое интересное, это, по-моему, еще было до изобретения или параллельно, да? Параллельно. Дело в том, что вот Лев Термен, он был одним из изобретателей телевидения, вообще телевидения. Но у нас, то есть те принципы телевидения, потом, которые были на Западе разработаны, были придуманы Львом Терменом. Сейчас переведет еще Тоня.
Yes, well, his ideas were in 1926, you see, and on those times, you see, our country didn't take his ideas, but in the West, the ideas of TV were processed.
Потом очень интересное, вот, на мой взгляд, изобретение было возможность изучения педали по записям разных выдающихся пианистов, способ пользования педалью.
And so they try to
fixate.
Just to study how the great musicians, pianists, used the pedal. Значит, и что делали, изучали, как и что?
Да, как
запись
педализации.
Запись.
Yes,
Ну что, адрес?
Paper,
you know? Yeah,
yeah.
Do you have a legal record?
Okay, it's yeah. We need.
Let's sign it with date.
Oh, okay.
We'll just sign these things, okay, and then put a date on them.
Okay.
Yeah. Today is what?
Today is what? Today is the 27th. So, something in everybody's house. Here we go.
This is a unical film. Unical.
Unical? Oh, no, no, color.
This is business. This is interesting.
Oh, yes.
Alice
is very interesting.
This film.
Copy. We'll make copies. This is historical.
In America. Oh.
But only for me.
Mm.
Only for me, not for business.
No. Speak Alice.
Yeah. We talk about it later.
Uh-huh.
But
спасибо вам большое.
Да, я с вами я прощаюсь. Вообще, я сегодня не смогу уже, так мы уже прощаемся.
Всем. So,
на концерт я не смогу быть.
Oh, you saying goodbye.
До свидания.